What's up guys, it's Pete here again for the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, and today we've got a guide on how to add follower alerts, donation alerts and subscriber alerts into OBS Studio for your Twitch or your YouTube gaming streams. The website or service that we're going to be using today is called Streamlabs. Now it used to be called Twitch Alerts, so if you've ever heard of people saying that they use Twitch Alerts to be able to notify of new followers and things like that, it's the same company, they've rebranded and it's now called Streamlabs. But it's basically the number one tool in terms of the amount of users using it. I think they state on their website that the top 25,000 streamers on Twitch and on YouTube, 80% of them are using Streamlabs software to be able to notify their viewers of new followers, of donations, or of subscribers. So it's a really, really popular tool, and it's very likely that your favorite streamers are using it as well. What it actually allows you to do is to completely customize the look and feel of these alerts. So basically, when somebody subscribes or starts following your stream, the Streamlabs software can notify OBS in a way of this new follower, and then the notification can appear on stream for the rest of your viewers. And you can completely customize how this alert appears. So you can have a custom image, custom sound, custom text, any way you really want to let your viewers know that you've got a new follower or a new subscriber or a new donation, you can customize that with Streamlabs. Now, the final thing to mention before we jump into the software is that this video will be fairly long because I want to cover it in detail and really explain all the options so that you can make the best decision for your stream. But I will have timestamps down in the description below. So if you want to skip ahead to a certain section, be sure to open up the description and click ahead to the certain parts of the video that you want to see. And also, if you're new here at the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, we have loads of videos like this helping you set up your stream and basically grow your gaming passion into a profession. So if you're new here, please do consider subscribing. But let's jump into the software. So the first thing that we want to do is to head straight over to the Streamlabs website, which is streamlabs.com, and we can connect our Twitch TV or our YouTube gaming account. So when you get to the website, click Launch Streamlabs, and next we'll be choosing which platform we want to connect. So for this video, I'm going to be using Twitch, but the process is exactly the same for YouTube gaming. Now log in with your Twitch credentials, and if it's the first time that you've connected Streamlabs to Twitch, you'll also probably get a window asking for you to authorize Streamlabs to access some minor details of your Twitch account. Click Authorize if you're happy to allow this kind of permission, and we will get taken to the Streamlabs dashboard. Now, as you can see, there are absolutely loads of features that Streamlabs offers. And to prevent this video from being 2 or 3 hours long, I'll be splitting the main features into separate videos. So for this video, we're going to be covering the alerts. So follower alerts, subscriber alerts, and donation alerts. The other kind of features, things like donation goals, chat boxes, and stream labels, we'll be covering those in future videos. So to start adding and customizing our alerts, we want to click the alert box option down the left-hand side. Next, let's scroll down to where we see the alert settings, and you can see we have separate tabs for follows, subscriptions, donations, hosts, and bits. We'll start with follows, so let's click that. Now, the first option is whether or not you want to enable showing an alert on your stream when a viewer clicks to follow you. For new and smaller streamers, enabling follow alerts encourages viewers to follow your stream, and they also notify you that someone has enjoyed what they've been watching. When you get a new follower, please do interact with them. Say hello, ask them a question. You really want to be building a community with all of your followers. And if somebody's taken the time to click follow on your Twitch page, then you know that they've enjoyed what they've been watching and you need to start a interaction, a friendship with them almost. So you might be asking, why would you ever want to disable follow alerts? Well, if you're a big streamer who gets new followers every single minute that they're streaming, then having an alert pop up on stream can be really quite distracting, both for you and for your viewers, since it happens so often. So if you're a big streamer, you might consider disabling this option. Since most of our community here at the Gaming Careers YouTube channel are learning to grow their channels, I'm going to leave these enabled and move on. The next option is the layout that you want for your follower alert. The three options here are text below the image, text on top of the image, or text to the right of the image. You're not forced to have an image in your alert, so if you don't want one, we'll cover that later, but I think it really helps with the viewer's engagement to have a funny GIF or something like that appearing when you get a new follower. Next, we have alert animation, and this lets you customize how your alerts show and hide when they trigger. So you can see here there are lots of different options for fading in, zooming in, bouncing or sliding in, and also the exact same options for when the alert has finished. I'd recommend just setting anything you like the look of for now, because later we'll come back and play around with these once we have a preview set up within OBS so you can actually see what these look like. Now the next option is a fairly important one to understand, and it's called message template. This is the actual message that will show on stream when somebody follows you. This squirrely bracket with name in the middle, that's a token, effectively just a placeholder, which will get replaced by the username of the person that's followed you. So if their name was, let's say, Gaming Careers, it would display Gaming Careers is now following. You can change this text to whatever you like, just make sure you leave in the squirrely brackets around the word name where you want Streamlabs to replace name with the username. I'm going to leave mine at the default because I think that looks fairly good. Next, we can set up the text animation, and there is some sample text to the right just showing you how the animation looks. There's some pretty fun ones in here, so choose something that you like the look of. For me, I'm going to choose Tada. Next, we get to choose an image and sound that play every time an alert is triggered. Streamlabs has a really decent sized selection of stock images and GIFs, as well as sounds that you can choose from, or you can upload your own by dragging and dropping. If you want your stream to really stand out, here's where you could spend some time in Photoshop, as well as like an audio program like Audacity, creating a custom notification that really matches your stream brand. But for the purposes of this video, I'll just stick with the default GIF and the default sound. Just as a quick note, if you don't want an image or a sound every time you get a new follower, you can click the little cross here to remove it. Next, we set the sound volume for the alert sound. So this can be anything between 0 and 100%. We can also add an alert duration. So this is the length that the alert will appear on your stream for. I don't really recommend setting this anywhere above 8 seconds, as I found 8 seconds is easily enough time for viewers to see and read the alert. And finally, we can set the alert text delay. So this is the number of seconds delay for displaying the text after your image and your audio show. So if you want to wait a few seconds for the animation to finish before the text shows, you can set that up here. Next, let's expand the font settings section. In the font box, we can enter the name of the Google font we wish to use for our alert. So you can see a full list of these fonts if you go to google.com/fonts. And you're also given a list of the top 5 most commonly used fonts. Font size is just the size of the font in pixels, and font weight is how thick or bold the font appears. So feel free to play around with these settings to get something that really matches what you want. Now, text color and text highlight color are the two colors that are used on the text in the alert. So as you might have guessed, text color is the color of the base text. So that would be the is now following. And text highlight color is the color of the highlight text, which is the name of the follower. So you can enter the hex value if you know it, or you can click and search for a color of your choice. Finally, if you're quite comfortable with the platform, you can add a variation to this alert if you want to randomize the messages or images or sounds. But for our example, we're done here, so we can click Save Settings. Now what we have done is we have set up the followers alert in Streamlabs. You can now set up similar or completely different alerts for when a user subscribes, donates, hosts, or gives you bits. Since we've already covered the follower alerts in a fair amount of detail, and some of the other tabs have similar settings, we're just going to skip ahead to the settings which are different. Subscriptions, for people that aren't aware, are for people that are partnered with Twitch. It allows viewers to subscribe to you, getting some sub-only perks for $5, and then you and Twitch will split that $5. If you aren't yet partnered with Twitch, I understand it's probably something that you want to get in the future, but you might as well leave this disabled, as viewers won't be able to subscribe to you anyway. If you are lucky enough to be partnered with Twitch, you'll see that the initial settings can be set up however you like, very similarly to the follower alert that we just covered. The only real differences are these two boxes down here: resub message settings and resub message text to speech. So the resub message setting allows you to show the viewers resub message as part of their alert. This also includes Twitch emotes. If you are going to enable this, I'd advise increasing the alert duration past 8 seconds, just so that you have time to properly read the message and your viewers do too. Now, resub message text to speech, that will have a voice of your choice read out the viewer's resub message. If you're going to enable this, then I would really recommend turning the spam security to low or medium, just to prevent the comment spam of somebody commenting, you know, VVVVVVV. You don't want that being read out by text to speech all the time. The final thing that I would recommend doing in the subscriber alert is adding a resub variation so that the message is slightly different for people that are resubscribing to you every month. To do this, we'll select add a variation. Name it resub and change the variation condition to month subscribed to is at least, and change the value to 2. Then you can play around with your resub alert as much as you'd like. The only thing I'll mention is in the message template, you can use the keyword months surrounded by squarely brackets, and that will be replaced by the number of months that the viewer has resubbed for. Make sure when you're done, you click save settings. The last feature that we're going to be setting up in Streamlabs is the donation alert. So this is for whenever a user clicks on your link and donates to you through PayPal or some other services. Now, before we go into customizing what the alert will look like, we first need to edit our donation settings. Let's add a donation method. So for me, I'm going to go with PayPal and enter my PayPal email. Next, let's choose a currency. This is just the preferred currency format that you wish to see in your alerts and around the Streamlabs dashboard. The donation page currency is just the currency you want your donation page to show. I'd recommend leaving this on Detect Automatically, which will automatically pick the currency that best suits the donator's geographical location. Next, the minimum amount is the minimum amount you want your users to be able to donate, and the suggested amount is just the placeholder amount on your donation page. So this is a suggested amount for the donator. They can obviously change it. I'll leave mine at the defaults with a minimum of $1 and a suggestion of $5. The preferred lingo option just allows you to choose between using the word donations or tips, so just choose whichever you think is more natural for you. And next, you should be given a link to your donation page. So this might not work until you've finished and click save, but it's effectively, this will be the page URL that you want to send your viewers to if they want to donate. So it's worth linking it in your Twitch profile somehow. Allow Pro Viewers, this is an option that allows viewers to donate some money to Streamlabs as well as donating to you. It'll give them a few more options in their donation message as an incentive, and it helps support Streamlabs and keep it running. There's absolutely no pressure to leave this enabled at all, so disable it if you want to, but if you are enjoying using Streamlabs and you found the service helpful, then it's a nice way to show your support. The button color allows you to change the color of the donate button on your donation page, and donation memo is a place to write a brief message that will be shown on your donation page, so saying your words of thanks for the person that's donating. Banner override, this allows you to set a URL path to an image for a donation banner. But if you just leave this blank, it automatically defaults to pulling your Twitch TV channel banner anyway, so I'm just going to leave it blank. Finally, profanity filter, this allows you to set a specific filter to prevent swear words from being included in people's donation messages. They can even automatically be replaced with happy words, although this doesn't obviously always read perfectly. You can also add custom bad words into a box below. So if you find people donating and they've found a loophole in the bad words filter and they keep donating using a certain phrase that you don't want appearing on your stream all the time, then you can add the custom words in this box below. When you're happy, click Save Settings, and then we can go back to the alert box and across to the Donations tab. So most of these settings you've seen before and you should know how to customize, so I won't bother going through them, but some of the new settings worth mentioning are the minimum donation amount to alert and the minimum donation amount to read with text-to-speech. So here you can set the minimum donation amounts required for the donation to be shown as an alert and also the minimum amount for the donation to be read as text-to-speech. So this is useful if you're getting spammed with lots of small donations just to abuse the text-to-speech bot. In the message template, you can use the amount word surrounded by squarely brackets to show the amount donated in your message. As with the other tabs, you can also add custom variations for certain donation amounts if you'd like to, but that will do it for me, so I'll click Save Settings, and now we'll look at getting these messages into OBS Studio. Now, if we go back to the top of the alert box page, you'll see a number of checkboxes and a lock to show the widget URL. To start, make sure that all the checkboxes that you want alerts for are checked, and then click the Show Widget URL link. This gives you a unique URL that we'll be using in OBS Studio, so copy the link and then let's open up OBS Studio. So in OBS, let's select a source that we want to add our alerts into, and then click the plus icon in sources and select to add a browser source. I'd recommend naming it something that you're going to remember. So for me, I'm going to put Streamlabs Alerts. And in the new window that pops up, you want to be pasting the URL into the URL box. You can change the width and height if you wish to, but this can be changed later by dragging it around. And you can also set the FPS. I'd recommend setting it to the same FPS that you stream at to avoid any kind of flicker issues. And the CSS, that can be left at its default unless you really know what you're doing. You shouldn't need to enable either of the bottom check marks, so let's just press OK. Now you shouldn't see anything really at the moment other than a blank box with the red border around that you can drag, move around and resize. One thing to make sure you've done is to make sure that this is on top of all your other sources so that you'll get alerts on top of your game and or on top of your webcam. I'm going to drag mine into the middle and sort of top area of my stream, and now it's time to test some of the alerts. So head back to the Streamlabs page and let's click Test Follower Alert, and then quickly Alt-Tab back into OBS so we can see our new follower alert showing up. I'm just going to reposition and resize mine a little bit, make it a bit more central and a little bit smaller, and then I'll test a subscriber alert. Now that we've got all of our alerts showing up in OBS, it's time to customize it properly. So go back to the Streamlabs website, go back to the settings that we were playing with before, and have a play around, change the animation, change the text type, change the sizes, change the colors, and just get something that you think is really unique and fun looking for your stream. Make sure that you're saving every setting that you change if you want to see it in the preview, and then test it again just by clicking that Test Follower Alert button. A final thing to mention is that when you actually are streaming, I find it useful to have the Streamlabs dashboard page open, possibly on a second monitor, because this will allow you to see all the alerts that are appearing on your stream without having to Alt-Tab, and then you can read messages from your followers or subscribers and also see the donation amounts. I hope you guys found this video helpful, and if you have got to this point in the video, please could you give me a thumbs up on the video just to let me know that it did help you out, and we can aim to create more videos around OBS Studio in the future. Also, if you're new to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, we've got quite a collection of videos now. We've certainly got quite a few on OBS Studio, so if you're having any trouble with your settings or adding sources, or if you want to learn how to do something like adding a music scroller to your stream, check out the Gaming Careers YouTube channel and subscribe if that's the kind of thing that you enjoy watching. Subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.